Hey guys, good morning. It's Tony. I just wanted to give you guys an update on my full crypto portfolio. As you guys know, I did sell about 80% of my doggy back when it hit 40 cents. I actually sold on the way up. I think I sold at 15 cents. And then I think I sold the rest of it around 39, 40 cents. So I am around 80% out on my doggy position for now. Apart from that, I did add from last time, I did add Chelo, and I did add a little bit of Anchor from the last time. I put up about 100 Chelo, and then for Anchor, I bought around 3,085. Each one I put in around 500 bucks. Matic, I have around 2,300. For Mana, another 500 bucks. For the Graph, which I actually think is a very solid project, I have 775, NKN, 720, Polkadot. I actually don't have any, but I like Polkadot a lot. So if you guys, I wouldn't buy at these prices, but the first time somebody asked me about buying it, I think it was around $12 or so, 16 bucks. And I think there's like a video out or something. But I think Polkadot is a really good project under the Ethereum blockchain. Doggy, you guys know that I had a crap ton of Doggy coin and I sold when it was like around 40 cents. Ethereum, I only have about half an Ethereum coin. Ethereum Classic, I have about 2,400. Bitcoin, I don't have too much Bitcoin, only 100 bucks. Bitcoin Cash, 648. XRP, I did have XRP a while back. I actually sold off because of the lawsuit that was actually on Ripple. So if I were to get back into XRP, I wouldn't actually get back into XRP until that lawsuit is actually over. And I think there might be a short-term sell-off on XRP after that lawsuit actually gets released or something happens, but I wouldn't buy into XRP right now. I think it's definitely, I definitely think at $2, it's super high up there. Can it definitely go higher? 100%. I definitely think XRP can definitely end up competing, not necessarily with Ethereum or Bitcoin, but it can definitely be used for, you know, international, like an international way of moving money. I do like XRP a lot. OX is basically a gambling token. Chainlink, I love Chainlink. I do think that if, you know, a big retail like Amazon, Walmart, Target starts accepting, you know, tokens or coins, I do think that Link would probably be the first. There's been a lot of rumors about Walmart implementing Link with their website. So take that with a grain of salt. I don't know how big that actually is or if it's going to come to fruition, but I do like Link as far as like a long-term play, because I do see Chainlink as like a big coin that would actually be accepted by retail as more so of a, you know, like as payment, right? Apart from Bitcoin. XLM, I do have a big position in XLM. I have about 10,200 coins. I do think that XLM is a heavy competitor to XRP. And if that lawsuit on XRP actually ends up finishing against XRP's favor, I do think all the money from XRP is going to go into XLM 100%. But take in mind, this is kind of a win-win situation because XLM and XRP charts are very correlated. You know, they move very frequently together. So if XRP actually loses their lawsuit, a bunch of that XRP money, if not most of it, is going to come into XLM. If XRP wins the lawsuit, not only will they get an influx more of a bunch of money going into XRP, but guess what? They're going to go into other competitors, which is XLM, which is basically a direct competitor to XRP. And guess what else is going to get pumped, right? Basic attention token. I do think that this is more so on the fact that I think that that is going to be, you know, a very big thing in the future where you're able to kind of tip people online, whether you want to, what is it called? Whether you want to like tip creators, tip people that are on websites, just tip people on Twitter, stuff like that. I do think that has a very, very big chance of succeeding. So long term, I do see BAT. It's barely at a 2 billion market cap. I can definitely see this doing a 10x, hitting 20 billion within the next couple of years. So I will be adding more to my BAT wallet. And I've been following this project for literally years. I got into BAT back when, I can't imagine, I don't remember how much BAT, but back when it was first starting on Reddit. And they barely released their BAT browser, and actually have on my previous phones the BAT browser where I would actually go through it and just kind of look at how much I've actually gained and stuff just by browsing the web. Like, you get paid to do these, like, just things that you regularly do, which I do think is a very big project that's going to be in crypto. And I will more than likely, BAT will probably be the token that I will be adding the most money to, just because I do think the project's going to be pretty big. And then again, Cardano, which is more than likely the main competition of Ethereum. I do think Ethereum is probably the best. I do think Ethereum is the best crypto right now, as far as technology, as far as blockchain tech goes. Ethereum all the way. I do think Ethereum can definitely surpass Bitcoin as far as usage. And I do think, I don't know if Ethereum can actually surpass Bitcoin as far as market cap, right? I definitely do like Ethereum. I do think it might be able to hit 9K from here, 9K, 10K. It's definitely a big possibility, maybe even more. But as far as usage, ADA is actually the competitor to Ethereum. And that's what I actually like to play. So, for example, what's the competition to Ethereum? Cardano. What's the competition to XRP? Stellar. Is there any competition to Basic Attention Token? No, it's the only one. So it's definitely a good idea to kind of hedge your position on where you think certain things are going, right? Or it's like basically buying Apple and also buying their competition, like Samsung or Microsoft or whatever, right? Which they tend to rally kind of equally, right? Or if you're doing stuff, if you're buying like Coke, you would also buy their competition, Pepsi, just to kind of offset certain things. For the most part, they're both going to go up at the same time, but in different ways, right? Well, yeah, this is my full crypto portfolio. Cardano, Basic, Stellar, Chainlink, OX, XRP, Bitcoin Cash, very little Bitcoin, Ethereum Classic, Ethereum, Doggy, well, not Doggy anymore. I think I only have like 50,000 Doggy right now, or like 100K Doggy. I don't remember how much I have. Polkadot, NKN, Graph, Mana, Polygon, Anchor, and Cello. And there's one more that I'm looking to very heavily invest in, and I will be releasing a video because I'm actually going through the white paper. So, you know, you guys don't have to do any of the work. I'm basically going to read everything and research just to kind of, you know, give you guys an idea of what I think is actually going to happen with the specific with this specific cryptocurrency. And it's actually backed directly by Coinbase. It already has a bunch of projects basically to be worked on in the future, but it's only one other crypto that I'm actually going to buy. And I think I actually have another crypto called Luna, which I bought like a grand of a while back, just because a friend told me to get into the project. But I do, like I said, I don't necessarily trade crypto based off of hype. Doggy was the only one that I actually trade based off of a hype. It's more so just, you know, buying it based off of which one do you think is actually going to run, what's their competition. And another little thing you can actually do to figure out which crypto might actually run: look at their history of wallets, man. If you guys see a bunch of money being poured in, let's say there's like, you know, 10 owners of one specific crypto, if there's like three people in there with a shit ton of money, there's probably a reason why there's big money being moved into there. You can actually check the history on the blockchain, but we'll go into that a different day. And then I will, like I said, there's one more crypto that I do like very, very much as far as what they're doing with their future projects. And it's not even tradable yet. But I'll definitely be talking about that one in another video, which I think that one is gonna, it's gonna blow up pretty good. And I really like that one a lot. So I'll see you guys later. Have a good day. If you guys want me to do any more TA and other stuff, definitely put it in the comments, like the video, all that good stuff. I'll see you guys later, man. Have a good weekend.